I think the biggest regret is that I all just lived and died as a person that no one knew. That's boring.
Your way out of hood might not be the way Bernard Hopkins said. I'm boxing my way out. You gotta think your way out.
The real story of Bernard is spectacular. The one he tells, maybe even better than that.
Right out of the penitentiary, no gold medal, no silver medal, blue collar worker, give something away. You had to kill me for it.
The guy was a bad kid.
I didn't care. I want what you got, give it to me, I'm taking it.
I've been arrested about 30 plus times.
He went to prison for real crimes.
I joined the boxing program in prison in 1984. I became the jailhouse champion.
He is face first into the canvas. Oh, a right uppercut!
Fought the best. He beat the best.
And since you're going to do that, you're going to be
showing. Bernard Hopkins is still moving fast, endurance, and he's 40.
He reconstructed himself.
You're dealing with a different individual with a different purpose.
I know my value. I am the undisputed champion of the whole wide world. And every time I step in the ring, the less they can pay me is $10 million. I know who I am.
Bernard.
The executioner.
Hopkins.
We had Raymond Rosen Projects, a place that I spent early in my younger life. My mother and father owned a house here. This is where I learned how to survive and fight and defend myself. The other gang used to come from up that way. They'd be shooting 22 guns, sawed-off rifles, and we all had to run in the house. But this was deep, man. This was no joke. Very few, if not, can't make it out of here. And if they make it out of here, they make it out of here for bad reasons. My father, Bernard Hopkins Sr., he had worked for the Philadelphia Sanitation Department. He was a big drinker and also a drug abuser. I mean, you know, it was 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and your father, like, he's sleeping, you know, that's not normal. It gets to a point where it ain't a big deal. You get accustomed to it. Substance abuse, I believe, played a role in his a short time on this earth. Yeah, y'all ain't in school today? Y'all go to school tomorrow? Why you in the school? All right, y'all gotta tell your papa to school, man. Just, all right? There's got to be a good reason.
You beat people up.
Do I beat people up?
Yes.
Yeah, but I do it legally, though. I get paid for it. It's only in the ring.
How much?
Oh, it depends. My mom, she was the head of the whole tribe. We call her Big Shirley. She was the neighborhood block captain. She was the neighborhood, the area. Everybody knew my mom, Shirley. My mother knew back then that she needed to get us out of that situation. It's negativity, drugs, guns. My mother back then had the vision of not being there. The whole concept of moving from North Philly to Germantown. Moving up to Germantown at the time was a thing of success. You're not in the suburbs, but you're not in the ghetto either. Straight down. This is the famous Germantown, Cobblestones. But this old corner, this is where I started getting in trouble. This whole area right here used to be my area. Germantown, I fought a lot of fights where there was amateur Golden Gloves, AAU tournaments. 77, 78, 79. I remember those days, man. You know, when you take all your trophies to school and you show everybody and you're proud that you won the Golden Gloves, you're proud that you won a fight. boxing and the amateurs became secondary. I mean, I became bored. I started feeling the peer pressure of the ghetto, of the neighborhood, and I started looking at how I was dressed and what my mother could afford or not afford.
The neighborhood was rough and the peer pressure is strong and the opportunities are limited and you make choices and at the time you don't know they're the wrong choices because so many people next to you are making the same ones.
Slowly but surely, the streets won.
Look at it like this. Either you're a lamb or you're a wolf. I chose to be the wolf. I don't know the experience, I don't know the feeling of being a lamb, but I know that a lamb don't have a chance in hell.
Intimidation. The stare. That message get around to everybody.
Part of the rules in the hood that I'll never forget, and it helps me in boxing. I'm gonna look you dead in your face, but I'll open my mouth, tell you that I ain't to be played with. And I always had that look. I was born with it. I didn't believe what nobody said. I didn't care. I didn't care if I knew that I was going to have some trouble out of you next week. I didn't care. I want what you got. Give it to me. I'm taking it. Fighting the assaults on this avenue, I'm about 50-0 with 20, 30-something knockouts. My sisters benefited from my behavior because when they had boyfriends, they thought twice about slapping them or bruising them or treating them wrong. The downside is they had less boyfriends.
I gave all reasons for anybody to hate Bernard Hopkins. I got stabbed 3 times, and that was random. It wasn't even the guys that I ever seen. It was Bernard Hopkins being, in this case, hard to believe, but a victim. I woke up, I was in the hospital with tubes everywhere. Tubes here, punch a lung, tubes down my throat, IVs. When I got home, I was like a hero because I almost died. All rational thinking is out of the window in the hood. Period. Nobody sits there and thinks about the repercussion of getting 50 years for taking a gun and blowing somebody's head off. They run off emotions, anger, stupidity. All the other stuff don't mean nothing. I've been arrested 30 plus times. Start off assaults, which led into robbery. It's the same thing. You know, a guy's not trying to give you what you want. You rough him up, you take it. It's assault, robbery. So it was hand in hand. One charge support the other. I had about one or two maybe auto thefts where I was in a car. One time I was driving. This other time I was with the person who we both stole the car. You faced the years that's been put in front of you. It's a world within a world. We call it the walls of China. The walls are so tall. Guards with scope rifles. A lot of people that came through there didn't make it out. All other inmates, they looking at the new fish. They looking for fear. They looking for body language to show fear. All eyes is on you. Now, you gotta establish yourself openly, not quietly, because you're sending a message. You gotta put them back in their lane. The first person to get out of the line, you punch them in the face. You learn the rules. I wasn't near the baddest guy in Greater Fort out of 3,000 to 4,000 inmates. No, hell no. No. Compared to the guys that was in there, I was a church mouse.